Welcome back to Downstairs and Dragons. We're going to be starting Evil Party episode 18 tonight, but there's not a whole lot left to do until we reach the end game, where the good party and the evil party will be facing off in mortal combat against one another. So, we're going to try and get all the little extra errands done before then. Yeah, recap. Last time our villains found themselves in the Feywild, they met the Queen of Witches, who sent them on an errand to go retake a lost keep of theirs that they lost to encroaching Celestials. So they went in, they met an enemy they had fought previously called a Harvestal that we made up for the campaign. They tried tricking their way in, but none of them could speak Celestial. Torment did a pretty good job getting in the front door without getting attacked, but eventually his cover was blown and they had to fight their way through everything. They discovered that the Celestials were in the middle of a ritual that seemed to be changing the land and the sky in this region. They interrupted it. And then they were escorted back to the castle of the Queen of Witches. They were rewarded with a Tree of Might. Then they had a nice little celebratory feast. And now I believe you wanted to have a long rest.
Yes.
You had previously animated one of the dead Harvestals, is that correct?
Yeah.
So you can keep it animated after 24 hours. Would you like to do that after your long rest?
Well, how long would be left after the long rest?
Not much.
Not much, but enough where you could redo the spell.
Because it'd probably only be like 2 or 3 hours, I bet.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay, so you are in the Feywild, and there is an armory available for you to shop at.
Hello!
I bolt to this armory.
Okay, you see Torment just take off, giddy with anticipation.
I just follow the string.
Okay, yeah.
Well, let's just follow.
After a little bit of questioning and getting directions, you're pointed in the location of the armory.
Right here.
Hey.
So, what would you guys like to purchase?
You first.
What do you got?
They've got a lot.
Like everything? Everything we ever desired?
They're a very well-established Feywilds castle armory, so they have a lot. Whatever you're looking for, there's a good chance they'll have it.
How much would you buy this for? And I'm just gonna unroll the Elder Shadow Drake hide.
Wait, no, that's not what I want to do. Just the Drake teeth. I'm just gonna first put like one Drake tooth down and be like, what's your best offer?
Okay, so the Elder Shadow Drake fangs. How many of them do you have?
I have 6.
You have 6.
One.
You have 1. Okay, they will buy those for 20 gold each.
Sold.
Deal.
Okay.
That's a good price.
How about the canine teeth?
The canine teeth they would buy for 25 instead of 20.
Sold.
Okay.
How about these toes?
The toes with the claws. So a little extra work needs to go into removing the claws from the toes.
Yeah.
So the, you know, time and labor would detract from the price. So you can expect 15 gold per toe with claw.
A done.
Could I get a pencil?
Yeah.
Thank you.
And how much could I get for all these gems?
Okay, would you like to sell them all right now, or
I'm gonna hold on to mine.
Okay.
I am too.
A little bit.
I just want to know what all mine are worth.
Okay.
Yeah, that's kind
of
what. I'm
you each have an identical set of gems.
Correct.
Yep.
Let me
just listening carefully.
Yeah, that's all. I'm just like curious.
So, a set of these gems is worth 500 gold.
What about the diamond specifically?
There's 5 gems per set.
Yeah.
6
gems.
Yeah.
So the gems are different sizes, but they're all valued at about 83 gold. 83.33 gold.
You. That's not a $300. That's not a 300 gold.
Damn.
That's an expensive spell.
I guess I'll just sell the gems for the 500.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
Okay.
Would I know if they'd be any more expensive not in the Feywild?
Like in Torlamain?
Yeah.
So the Feywild is not the plane of the elemental plane. It is not from the caves of the earthen region, right, which are rich in minerals. There, they would be worth much less.
Okay,
so
selling.
In the Feywild, they're about the same.
How much for this?
500, you say? That seems like a good deal.
Oh, the Elder Shadow Drake scale. In this case, it is 2 plates that cover the Drake's breast. And one of those would probably be worth about 50 gold.
What about this vial of Drake blood?
Also a plate.
Okay.
I have a vial and a third.
Vial and a third of Drake blood. So if you had, it's been a little while. They take a look at the blood, and the blood has started to coagulate.
Yummy.
It's been some time. It's kind of one of those resources that you want to acquire quickly and sell quickly, or at least find a way to preserve. And the blood did not preserve. It'll sell for about 5 silver because the blood can still be used, but not for any expensive spells.
How about the heart?
That's probably fucking gross right now.
Probably.
So the heart is mostly muscle. You drained it of blood. It's kind of rotten.
What about this?
Not interesting.
Ash.
Well, the heart, they're not interested in purchasing.
Killed it myself.
I'll sell my Drake blood
for
5 silver.
You can get...
Just
I'm going to keep the Drake blood, actually.
Are you going to keep it?
Yeah. I'm going to give it to the Cabal.
Oh my God. Hey, guys. You could get 15 gold per vial of incubus or succubus ash.
Nope.
Sold.
Okay.
What about this vial of... Orox.
Completely worthless.
You are selling
a pocket.
Yeah.
You're selling your incubus?
Yep.
Gone.
Why'd you sell him?
He didn't love me. What about this wand?
What's a wand?
Detect magic.
Wand of detect magic. I'd have to look that up.
I'm appalled. And by criticizing him for denying his love, I'm going to pull out my vial and sell it while I'm just continuously criticizing him. You honestly are the lowest piece of shit. Did you even love him? pocket the gold.
Um, 100 gold.
And this wand of secrets.
We're not even buying anything. We're just selling.
25 gold.
Keeping that.
Okay.
I'm just imagining Torment just taking everything slowly off of his back.
Just out of curiosity, what about this wood?
I guess I'm sorry now.
Yeah. What about this Cambrian spear? What about this?
What's the subtext for the whip?
Whip of warning. It's a weapon of warning. Just hold on. I just want to know how much
it is.
Uncommon.
Dangerous for you.
I thought you bought that.
I think.
Yeah.
You did.
Yeah.
You did.
100.
I'll keep it.
Yeah.
If it was worth more, I would have.
What about this,
fuck you.
This Cambrian spear?
Okay, that's the, That's a spear that does 1d6 fire damage?
Yep.
Okay. Is it a plus one weapon?
Yep.
Yep.
Okay.
That's math right.
$1,000.
Yep!
Jesus.
I'm selling mine too.
Okay.
Yes, please.
How?
Holy shit, that doubled my income. Oh, God.
How much for a flame tongue?
Flame
long
tongue.
Sword, right?
Flame tongue long sword.
Oh. It's a rare to buy.
Yeah. Oh,
guys,
rare?
I'm freaking
yeah,
out right now. That's That was intense. So you want to give a little hop? Oh, shit. Ulfgar's got 2,000 gold.
Me too.
Good thing that turned.
2,000 for a flame tongue longsword.
Oh, I sold these.
Sold those.
How about a ring of storing, my good chap?
That's uncommon.
I wish.
Or spell storing? Okay.
No, it's rare.
Okay. I'm just double checking. Ring of animal influence. That's not it. Ring of RS. Shooting star, spell storing, rare. Okay. Rare. You're lucky. It's 1,000.
Oh, son of a bitch!
How much for this Dragon Slayer longsword?
I want to hear a decision first.
Wait for
motherfucker!
What is it?
He's trying to buy a ring of spell storing for
1,000. I can't buy it. No, I can't.
Why not?
Because I only have 1,000. And I need other shit.
Like what? Oh, yeah, like armor.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, okay.
Okay,
son of a bitch.
Dragon Slaying?
Yeah. To sell.
To sell.
And it is plus one.
Bits of.
I
see
that.
In there.
Yeah. I'm just saying it is a plus one sword.
Thank you.
I know,
but what I'm saying is it's an actual weapon.
Yeah, I know.
In the book.
I know.
Okay.
You don't understand.
Oops.
In the DMG, it's always a plus one weapon.
Yeah. Oh, is it?
Oh.
I didn't know.
I got you, bro.
2,000.
I will trade you this Dragon Slayer sword for that flame tongue.
That's how much I said the flame tongue was 1,000, right?
No, you said 2,000.
Okay, yeah, you can do
but
a straight
trade. I'll take the 1,000.
No, you won't.
Damn!
Let's be honest now.
Let's be honest.
I was.
Wait, what's the flame tongue do?
Dope.
Flame
it's
tongue.
It's sweet. I say a command word for a bonus action, and it inflames itself, and it gives an extra 2d6.
I hope you catch yourself on fire.
Yeah, how's
the
that
flames
work?
Do not burn the wielder.
Exactly. See, I'll trade the two swords.
So you're going to trick them.
Here's the thing.
You
can use a bonus action to speak this magic sword's command word, causing flames to erupt from the blade.
That's fucking
These
dope.
Flames shed bright light in a 40-foot radius and dim light for an additional 40 feet. While the sword is ablaze, it deals an extra 2d6 fire damage to any target it hits. The flames last until you use a bonus action to speak the command word again, or until you drop or sheathe the sword. So remember, it does take a bonus action to ignite the sword.
So is it a plus one or no?
I don't think so.
No.
No.
Okay.
It makes sense that it's not.
It's
pretty dope.
I'm just going to double check, because like those magical effects, like there could be a rule that says all these things are plus one.
There's... Right.
I don't think so.
Do you have any...
Yeah, it's not.
Elemental gems?
Elemental gems. Nope, wrong way.
Hold up. Torment.
Yeah?
If you want to buy that ring...
Yeah?
I might be willing to part with my hide to get you some armor.
How much is the hide?
I haven't even checked how much the hide gets. But I'm just talking about like turning the into like dragon, like elder shadow drake high armor.
Okay.
How
much is it, Jem? Hold on.
Wait, what?
The ring was 1,000.
Yeah.
No, how much is an elemental gem?
Elemental gems. Which ones do you want? There are blue sapphires, yellow diamonds, red corundum, and emerald.
Anything but fire.
Anything but fire. Okay. So three rolls. First one. Oof.
That doesn't sound good.
I rolled a six, so 500 GP.
Okay.
So that would be the blue sapphire. Yellow diamond. 200 for the earth elemental. And emerald for the water elemental is 500.
I'm going to buy the earth elemental one.
Okay.
How much for a pair of winged boots?
Winged boots. Good choice. Boots with wings on them.
Yes.
Okay.
That's right.
Uncommon.
And then, just letting you know, Dieter.
Yep.
I'm taking my bag of 100 gold off the cloak, finally.
Oh, yeah. Okay, winged boots, 500.
So, Ulfgar.
Yeah.
Done.
You should
okay.
get that checked out.
I'm like, oh, should I see how much it's worth?
Yeah.
Right now?
Yeah.
Alright. Is it a guy or a girl?
Well, it's quite large. There are a number of clerks available, so.
Oh, sir. How much may I. I'm trying to sound dignified.
Yeah.
How much may I get for this Elder Shadow Drakehide?
Let's see. You're trying to sound dignified. What kind of a check would that be? Persuasion? Make a persuasion check.
So for the winged boots, is it 4 hours per long?
That's right, I'm bad at those. Bad at those. Persuasion? 4.
Page 214.
Thank you.
4. Yeah, you come off sounding like a...
Idiot?
Like an idiot.
That's what I am.
You're very transparent.
Yeah. However,
okay.
He's going to question how I skin this so well.
Yeah, you got a nat 20 on skinning the damn thing.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
This dude's impressed.
He's kind of torn between kind of, like, being insulted
like
and also, like, damn, look at this. The edges are clean. You got all the good parts.
I might not speak too well, but I do some things right.
Oh, that's a good question. Let's see.
Where would I find that?
See if I can find something that I can look at.
It's in here.
I need to
just look alphabetically. Not in T's.
This is what I get for not going through the ritual. Is that all 7? I'm missing one.
There you are. Oh, man.
Done what?
My ritual.
Hey, Samantha.
Hmm.
How much do you think the Elder Shadow Drake hide would be worth if Ulfgar got a nat 20 on skinning it?
Oh, yeah.
How much is dragon hide worth?
I have no idea.
How big is it? Like,
so,
isn't it large?
That's what I was checking. It should be a large creature, but it could be smaller. Or larger. I don't know.
Just a fucking huge hide.
Large dragon. So, 2x2 square on a battle map.
Jeez, that could make a ton of stuff.
Yeah, it could.
I can make armor for everyone.
Well...
For 2 people.
Probably 2 people, yeah.
Well, I'm gonna be buying armor.
Yeah. I can make armor for me.
You would probably decrease your.
Yeah,
system.
You know what?
Well,
what
kind
really
of armor would that make?
Hide armor.
Or sustain it.
Or you could use it to make leather armor.
Okay.
But would it be specially enchanted?
It would have its own magic attached to the hide.
Okay, so look up some enchanted leather armor.
Armor. Come on, where's that plus one armor?
It's the very first entry.
Adamantine armor?
Never mind. Second page.
There we go. Okay, so. Oh, okay. Okay. So.
Leather armor is less. That's 11 plus your dex. Hide is like spell plus your dex, so it actually would be lower.
Do it.
That's not bad. Okay, it would be worth 3,000 gold.
Don't it! Bob!
I think it's that 20 roll that got you that much money.
Fuck. I would do it, Ulfgar.
Plus, I rolled a 6 on my die 6.
So I think I need to sell it.
Do yeah. it.
Sir.
This is, wonderful. Beautiful material. And armor made from it would be absolutely incredible. It would retain some of its shadowy qualities. Like, he takes it and he waves it, big as it is, through the air, and you can see, like, it leaves trails of darkness in the air.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
This is
if you use this armor, can we transport through darkness?
Well,
I think that may be possible.
Oh god. I don't know if I want to sell it. No, the mutiny. 3,000 gold, dope ass armor.
Let me see if I can find something comparable. Like maybe like a cloak of teleportation.
Guys, I'm freaking out right now.
The only thing that I can think of is this laser. But it's not really.
Well, one of the Elder Shadow Drake's abilities was jumping from shadow to shadow.
Yeah.
Just whoop!
Yeah.
So.
Just. Oh my god, get like hide leather of teleportation.
Oh.
I'm thirsty. Where are my cloaks?
I'm freaking out right now.
Cloaks.
So they're under sea. And I'm under D as douchebag. My rarity is common.
Cloak of invisibility. Legendary. No, that's too much. I know there was something of teleportation. Maybe it was
ring?
A ring of teleportation? Staff?
I can't believe 3,000 gold.
Yeah, that's...
Oh my god.
Damn good.
How much did we find in the Dragon Horde? Not that much.
Enough for each of us to get 300 gold.
Yeah.
And some to go to the party. Like
yeah.
500 went to the party.
So...
Yeah.
And I took no. I think it was 200 gold because I took.
Oh, helm of teleportation, rare, requires attunement. This helm has 3 charges. While wearing it, you can use an action and expend 1 charge to cast the teleport spell from it. The helm regains 1d3 expended charges. What is the teleport spell? What are its limitations? Or maybe I'll just copy the ability from
the monk.
No.
Because like they have the shadow stepping ability.
No, the ability from the Elder Shadow Drake itself.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that would work too. Because that would be super fucking dope armor, depending on like how we fight. If we fight in the light, I'm fucked.
Shadow jump 3 times a day. An Elder Shadow Drake can travel between shadows as if by means of a dimension door spell. This magical transport must begin and end in an area of dim light or darkness, and the distance must be no more than 60 feet. That sounds reasonable to me.
That is.
So yeah, an armor made with this hide would have that property. And if you wanted to dump extra money into making that armor, you could make it +1 armor.
Oh.
And it would be leather.
And you could make 2 sets. It could be leather, it could be hide. It could be studded leather.
Studded.
Shit.
Yeah, you got some great potential with this material.
It's your decision.
While he's trying to make a decision, I would like to buy some splint armor.
Alright.
Splint armor.
Guys,
okay.
I need advice.
What's up, old guy?
This hoid that I got
is
beyond what I believed.
Mm-hmm.
I have a couple options.
Shopping.
I can sell it for 3,000 gold.
Splint. 200 GP for splint.
Okay.
Yep. Or we can make armor out of it and teleport through shadows.
That's dope.
I know. I'm freaking out right now.
Who would wear this armor?
Probably me, maybe you. You need some armor.
It's only enough to make, like, 1 set of armor?
Two.
Your AC would go down.
but if I can invest more money and make it good armor.
Okay, so the armor table has a strength rating. Like, what's that?
For which? For the splint?
Like, splint is strength 15?
You have to have a strength of 15.
I have 16.
Gotcha. Okay. See, I thought so, but I thought maybe it was like, you can only benefit from it.
No, I can't.
No.
Plate strength 15.
Full plate?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was 17.
Nope.
I guess.
While they're finished up shopping, I'm going to go attune to my new things and put on my new armor.
Okay, you're done. What things did you buy?
Oh, I would like to sell my old armor.
Okay. What was your old armor?
It was my starting armor, so scale mail.
Wow, you went this long without getting new armor?
Yep.
And your AC is still 19?
No, it's 20 now.
No, I'm...
Hey, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
There was something...
I meant before...
Well, I have a plus one shield.
Okay, never mind.
Yeah, shield.
I get it. That's
right.
Never mind. Scale mail?
Yeah.
You can get 25 gold for that.
Okay. I don't need it.
Yeah, there's like
scales
no
scales
way.
No more.
Even if I get plus one, like armor, there's like I'm going down. Like if I get plus one hide armor, I'll be at 14. No, I'll be at 15 again.
And then you'd be able to jump through.
I'd be able to jump through shadows. What is it, 3 times a day?
3 times a day.
That's so dope.
60 feet.
How much extra would that cost?
To, like, make it? I don't know. I'm still freaking out.
You're supplying the materials.
Yep.
So the armor itself, because the materials are magical, it would only be the cost of the armor. Like, to make it.
Oh, shit.
Ulfgar, do it.
Damn.
If you want to spend extra money to make it better, the option's there.
Let me throw money at you.
We do it?
Yes.
To your question.
Or,
what I bought?
Oh, yeah. What did you buy?
I bought the splint armor, the flame tongue, and the winged boots.
Okay, flame tongue. I gotta find my little cool table of extra effects.
Oh, yeah!
All it is
fucking
new. So you can layer it.
Damn, where is it? Oh, here we go. Minor property. For the flame tongue. Harmonious. Attuning to this item takes only 1 minute.
Oh, cool.
Question.
Done.
Yeah. Could I, in theory, make scale mail out of it? The drake hide?
Scales are actually made of metal.
Oh, okay.
Let's see.
But it says it's made of leather covered with overlapping pieces of metal.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you could.
What? Yeah, my days, man.
You are absolutely correct. Scale mail is leather armor with scales on it.
Yeah, I read it, so I was like, oh boy.
How does that work?
What?
Are you listening the whole thing?
Are my wings going to have minor property?
Yes, they are. Okay, winged boots. 15. Unbreakable. The item can't be broken. Special means must be used to destroy it.
That's cool. So I'm gonna go put on my new armor and attune to my new item.
Sweet, okay.
Question.
Yeah.
In theory, could you make it into a breastplate by, like, overlapping it more, like, using... Because all it is the breastplate just covers your torso instead of your entire body.
The breastplate itself uses, like, padded quilting for comfort, but it is not a leather armor. It is metal that you strap to yourself.
So, scale mail it is.
God.
Yes!
How much money do I have to throw at that for it?
Okay, so it would all... You're providing the materials. You're not buying Elder Shadow Drake scale mail.
That's true.
So, it would be the cost of scale mail.
Oh, okay. God, 50 gold?
50 gold.
Yeah.
But are you going to make it a plus one?
Yes.
How much would it be to make it a plus one?
To make it a plus one.
I will easily do that.
These are going up.
Because that's 14, that'd be 15. So then I have an AC of 16.
Same.
Plus we can teleport through shadows.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
It's
going to
be so fucking easy.
Okay. Oh my
It's what? Going. I rolled really high.
Fuck!
Rare.
Oh. Fuck!
So, 5,000.
Oh! Okay, never mind. Well, that's fine. No,
that's at this location. The materials that they need to make plus one armor, they are low on, and it is hard to come by.
Okay.
At another location.
You probably have better luck.
Oh my god.
I'm sorry.
Especially with the agent discount.
I'm actually going to keep
with the agent discount now.
Okay.
Over?
Yeah.
Keep it.
Reed City.
Oh, okay. Good.
All right. I'm sorry.
It was a pleasure just seeing it.
So
please come by if you have more.
Yes. Yeah. Or send a pigeon or something.
Right.
Oh my god. Wait, can a pigeon get here?
From where?
Or from the noble own from Torlemaine.
Oh, where's Torlemaine?
It's in the other realm, not in the fae.
Can you translate, please? Where's this Torlemaine?
Just tell me can't bring a pigeon here.
You cannot bring a pigeon here.
You cannot send?
Send. Yes, yeah,
send.
Yeah,
a pigeon would not make the flight.
I'll come back if I ever get something like it.
Please do.
I take my scroll of magic weapon off my cloak.
Okay.
And ask how much he'd purchase for.
that's based on the spell level, right?
Yeah, I think that's a second level.
Oh.
Yeah, please find out.
I am. Oh. I know it's not first.
Scroll.
I don't think that'd be fucking crazy. Magic jar. Hand. Armor. Mad weapon. Second level.
W. Oh, spells.
Magic weapon.
Oh, okay. Here we go. What is it?
After going.
Second level.
Never mind.
Second level. Uncommon.
Never mind.
Excuse me.
I should probably see if they have, like. Oh, oh, got it.
150 gold.
And sold.
Oh, sir. I actually have a question. Do you have any braces? Braces here. Of defense. Do you have any braces of defense? I'll come out and say.
Okay, I can.
Okay. So I'd wear the braces, and then I'd wear the gauntlets over them. Yes. Because that makes sense.
There you go.
Yep.
Bracers of defense, rare. Requires attunement.
Yep. Which I no longer have. I have one open attunement.
5,000.
Yep, that's what I thought.
Sorry.
Did you roll high?
Oh, yeah.
If I had the braces of defense plus that armor, my AC would turn to 17.
Can you wear the braces of defense with armor?
Oh, I can't. You're right.
Yeah.
You're right. Good point.
Oh, do you have any javelins of lightning?
Yep.
Javelins of lightning.
There we go.
I think that was uncommon, right?
Yes, it was.
Okay.
If it's low enough, you get, like, dual.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
300.
I'm gonna buy... Can I buy... Do you have two of them?
They have several, yeah.
I'm gonna buy two.
There you go. Okay.
Shit. So 600?
Yeah.
What about a pearl of power?
Pearl of power.
Enlightening.
Is that right? So 2173 minus 600 would be 4,500.
Hey,
yeah.
Gold
still?
100.
Yep.
Damn.
Sold. 4,573. That's like what I wanted to buy. So now I have 1,573. Hopefully to get plus one arm Elder Drake scale mail armor. That's a thing.
I'm down to 361 gold after all my shopping.
Okay, so you bought two javelins of lightning.
Yes, I did.
Are you doing any other shopping?
Because the only thing else I wanted was the brazen defense, but now I'm getting the armor, so I don't really need it. Unless there's like a like some other type of great axe. I already have a plus one great axe.
Yeah.
So I don't know if there's like
or something, but
plus two would be way too expensive. That's like very rare, I think.
Oh, is it?
I think so.
Well, I think a plus one was uncommon.
Adidas. I'm gonna buy the ring of spell storing too. That you said for 1,000.
Okay.
Oh, you are gonna get that.
Yeah, it's basically 5 extra spell slots.
Oh shit.
So I'm gonna need it.
Then that's not the pearl power? Or are you getting
pearl.
Both of them?
Wait, I should actually probably buy one or the other. Ring of spell storing only.
What's the pearl power do?
Recharges a spell slot.
There's a limitation on it too.
Yeah, I'm just gonna buy the ring of spell storing.
Okay.
What should I do with my life?
I'm ready to do minor properties for your stuff. So what did you buy other than the two javelins?
I did not buy anything. I don't think there's any like special like axe other than the berserk axe, and I don't want that because it's cursed.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah,
so
we're just waiting to go back to
yeah,
first javelin. 17 waterborne. Waterborne. Item floats on water and other liquids. Its bearer has advantage.
What a throwback.
Yeah. Its bearer has advantage on strength athletics checks to swim.
Nice.
Nice.
Second javelin. I've rolled plenty.
Wait, do you have to attune to those?
I don't think so.
Okay, good. I was just checking.
Nah.
So, wait, it was, what was the first one?
Waterborne.
Waterborne.
Advantage on swim.
Got it.
And it floats.
That one I don't like. Oh, there we go.
Do you have to attune to both of them?
I just rolled a 20. Roll twice. Discarding other 20s.
But I'll two more times.
Yeah.
So I get four.
Illusion. The item is imbued with illusion magic, allowing its bearer to alter the item's appearance
awesome.
In minor ways. Such alterations don't change how the item is worn, carried, or wielded, and they have no effect on its other magical properties. For example, the wearer could make a red robe appear blue, or a gold ring look like it's made of ivory. The item reverts to its true appearance when no one is carrying or wearing it. So the second property for this javelin. 5. Gleaming. This item never gets dirty.
Ah.
It's a very, very, very pretty javelin.
Yeah.
And it can never be stained with blood, which is either a good thing or a bad thing, depending on how you look at it.
Yeah.
But you can make it look like it's stained with blood.
I'm going to make it basically, I'm going to make it look just like super dwarf and.
And
then.
Angular with runes.
Mm-hmm. Runes, maybe some gems imbued into it.
Yeah. Cool.
Make it look dope as shit.
Okay.
The power of lightning.
Torment, what did you buy?
A gem and a ring.
What was the gem?
The earth elemental thing.
Earth elemental. Okay, that's not going to have any property.
I think so.
The ring will.
Oh, okay.
I already rolled that. There we go. That's a new one. Sentinel. Choose a kind of creature that is an enemy of the item's creator. The item glows faintly when such creatures are within 120 feet of it. We'll go with Celestials. Because why not?
That's what, hey, oh, Sentinel?
Yeah.
What glow has that?
Mara.
She still has to buy stuff.
Yeah.
Do you have anything to sell?
I sold it all already.
Okay.
I think I threw that for long.
You're looking for, like, a +1 shortbow, longbow, crossbow?
I'm going to try for a +2 shortbow.
+2 shortbow.
Yeah.
Yay.
Go big or go home.
Right? That doesn't work, then maybe I'll try the +1.
Where's your gold
yeah.
value?
Oh my god, guys, what if I had a +2 great axe?
Guys, I don't know what to unattune to.
Oh boy.
What do you have?
That's a big decision.
Okay.
The only thing that I don't use...
That's going to be expensive.
Shit.
4,000.
Do you have to have that attuned for it to work?
Yeah,
no.
We got enough for that.
Okay. You want a +1?
I think.
Yeah, the price on a +1.
That's not
bad. That's better. 300.
300? Yeah, I'm going to buy that.
Okay.
For a what?
A +1 shortbow?
I thought it was a +2.
No, that was 3,000.
Now,
oh,
you can
what was it, 4,000?
Get some special
something
ammunition.
Like
yeah, you can get +1 ammunition also. 2d8 20 plus 20 arrows, so you technically have plus 2.
Yeah.
How much would that be?
Oh, I'm not running. Ammunition, weapon, plus 1.
So it does have to be attuned?
Yep.
Fuck.
I mean,
what else do you have attuned?
Oof, you have a bonus to attack and damage rolls made with this piece of magic ammunition. The bonus is determined by the rarity of the ammunition. Once it hits a target, the ammunition is no longer magical. So keep that in mind.
Sorry, repeat that one more time.
Sorry.
When you use the ammo, after it's used, it's no longer magical.
Okay.
But you get...
we're probably going to have to attune to...
You get a collection of
them. Oh, you're right.
Shit. Oh, this piece of magic.
No, we're definitely going to...
So the individual arrows, not a quiver of arrows.
Hey!
But that option's still available.
How much would it be to, like, make a quiver of arrows magical or something? However you do it.
Like 20 arrows?
Yeah.
Whatever I roll times 20.
Do it.
But if you want to get, like, a few nice arrows, plus ones are uncommon.
So, Dieter,
mm-hmm.
we have to attune to our armor.
Our Shadow Drake stuff?
It would only make sense because we are teleporting with it. The ability.
But the magic is inherent to the armor, but then you have to magically connect with the armor, so yeah, I would say attuning.
Fuck. Shit, yo.
Unless you can find some kind of similar magic armor or cloak or cape that doesn't require attunement.
I think they all do.
Well, you might not get armor from it.
I don't have any more open attunement slots.
What else do you... Wait, what else are you using? Like, what's the other attuning?
I have my cloak of protection, which I could get rid of, but... And then my Rod of the Pact Keeper, which I can't get rid of.
What's your third one?
The whip, which I'm going to unattune to.
Which I'm getting. He's going to give to me. However,
my third one right now is the Ring of Spells Throwing.
I think I need to keep my I need my Gauntlets of Ogre Power.
Yeah.
Because they give me another plus one to attack.
Yeah.
Right.
Or to hit.
Is poison expensive?
And then.
Oh, the Dagger of Venom?
Well, I mean, I was thinking, like, poison for the arrows, but...
Oh, that should be in the player's handbook.
What about... Oh, gosh. I could unattune to my... No, I can't. I need my cloak. Unless I get...
Tools.
No, I need the plus one. Because I'll be...
Realistically, we could just go without the...
Poison.
Okay,
basic,
so
vial. 100 gold.
The scale mail... If I'm able to get plus one,
you
my
can
AC
find
would be
it
17.
On page.
If I get plus one,
it's a
barbarian,
and that's without the cloak.
Where the hell is it?
So,
it's if you get plus
poison.
One,
I'd be willing to separate with my cloak for the armor,
and same. That's where I'm at too. So,
let's.
Oh, poison. Oh,
we have to see how much it costs.
153.
How much do you have left?
Okay. And while I'm looking
Don't
at this,
worry.
Can
I have,
you check the price of a dagger of venom?
Yes.
Oh, I also have my dragon scales at the.
You sold those though.
That I sold.
Yeah, you sold the dragon scales right away.
Yeah.
No, I mean the ones that are at the cabal.
Oh yeah, you do have those.
Yeah. I just remembered about those.
Okay.
Okay. Rare. Dagger of venom.
So, in the meantime... Actually,
what's split armor made of?
Okay,
yeah. In the meantime...
2,000. Which is not a bad price for rare.
Do you have that?
Torment's still in the room, right?
You're all still in the room, yeah.
You should have... Oh, dude.
How much gold do you need?
200.
Wait, for what? What do you need?
A dagger of venom, which is a rare...
It's a rare dagger. And so that way, if I'm using my plus one short sword and my dagger in the offhand...
What?
Like...
Oh,
it could be awesome.
So
dagger venom. This you gain plus one bonus to attack and damage rolls made with this weapon. You can use an action to cause thick black poison to coat the blade. The poison remains for 1 minute. When hit, DC 15 constitution saving throw or take 2 die 10 poison damage and become poisoned for 1 minute.
Shit.
I want to help you, but I also want to keep the 1500 for this.
Here's 200 gold.
To try to get plus one. Oh, you're the best.
You're just gonna hand me 200 gold?
Wait, what about the party gold?
That's why I was looking at Torment. I'm like,
what are we spending that on?
Yeah, just take out the party gold.
Can I still, like, 200 of that party
gold? Oh, we're buying potions with the party gold.
That was the plan, but I can give you 200 of the party.
Yeah. It's going towards the party.
That's why I'm erasing.
And then I'll take it.
Okay, there you go.
All of my money.
So.
I have, like, 46 gold.
Dagger Venom and DMG 161.
No, yes.
Okay.
I can't believe we actually had that much in like our.
I gave you the whip.
Did you? Okay. Yeah. I have the whip.
Because I need the ring of spell storing is.
Ooh, interesting. The Dagger Venom's minor property is temperate. The bearer suffers no harm in temperatures as cold as negative 20 degrees Fahrenheit or as warm as 120 degrees Fahrenheit.
Nice. Wait! Isn't that the same thing that I have on my other thing?
I have no idea.
Probably.
On my Cloak of Elvenkind. That's the same thing I have on there.
Okay.
So, hey. I got double of that.
You're just, like, extra comfortable.
Yep.
But not after that. Just extra comfortable.
Mm-hmm. I forget so that the cloak gives us plus to eight, or saving throws to...
Yes, it does.
But I mean,
I don't have those modded yet, though. I like left them on, and I just do it when I roll.
I just have a plus one right there.
I'm still willing to say.
I mean, I'm gonna
what
do.
What page is that dagger about?
Like, if I can get plus one Elder Shadow Drake Scale Man.
161.
Let me double check.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Just a second.
Yeah, 161.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just gonna.
Okay, anyone else doing any other shopping?
Am I attuned to my stuff?
Sure.
Yay.
I'll attune to the whip then.
Oh, that's back home. Alright.
I still have the drink blood.
Where's...
yeah.
We're not gonna get Scott back.
Why's that?
What?
He's at the temple entrance.
Who is?
The temple that we ported to. In the Shadowfell.
I don't really care.
Well, you guys could choose to go out there.
You can always... Yeah, you can go back to that temple and then go back to the Shadow Temple and...
Well, no, he didn't teleport us to the Shadow.
Yeah.
He's outside.
Chilling outside the normal temple.
Oh, oh God.
Plus we have to kill some of these trees.
Oh, yeah. He's probably like, where the fuck did you go?
Dude, he's chilling.
Right,
mom and I
didn't run out of grass.
Well, hold on. If you're gonna use that extra, are you gonna use the whip? Are you attuning to the whip and then just getting rid of your cloak?
Almost
so we have the whip.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I think the whip is very useful. For
how many attunement slots has Mara?
I have all three of mine attuned.
So okay. Do I.
We're all full.
I mean,
getting all full. Okay.
I mean, I'll take it. Maybe if I get rid of my hat of disguise.
Yeah.
At some point, we need
it attuned because of the whole surprise thing.
Yeah.
What?
We need it to be attuned.
What?
The whip.
I had that attuned.
Oh, okay.
I thought we were talking about Mara's hat.
Oh, no.
Yeah. I mean, if she gets rid of her hat eventually, that's fine. But.
I don't see that happening, though.
It makes it easier for us to go through Torlamine with it, like, significantly.
What are you going to do for the dagger? Don't
yeah,
you
we think it's
no, you don't got to be a twink.
That's
what I looked
hat.
At. I'm
damn.
But yeah, no, we want to keep the whip. It's been very helpful for us.
Yes, it has.
Okay, that's fine. We'll just keep on going now.
Okay, yeah. Do you want to... request assistance from the Eladrin to head back to Torlamain or any other location on the material plane.
Back to Scott?
I think
how
we should go back
is...
to Torlamain.
I also think that.
Well,
how far
we...
is Scott from
Well, remember
Torlamain?
What our plan was? To poison all the trees on the way back?
Well, we didn't want to do that.
We did.
It was 4 days to Fallbrook and then to the Ruined Temple it was another 2 days.
So it'd be
six days.
That's fine.
That works for the timeline.
Okay.
Alright, we'll do that.
Do we have enough rations?
I have 22 on me.
We
so
Scott
yes.
And
Scott has 42.
Okay.
So, yeah, yeah, we're good.
And let's, you know, raise some havoc in the pretty town.
Yeah, we could do that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
With our newly attained equipment.
Okay. And then we'll go armor shopping when we get back.
Yeah.
Yes. And
potion shopping.
We might not have money for potions.
No, because if I... Because... we'll talk about it later. Let me get there.
I'm really hopeful for the plus one armor, but...
If you can't get
I'm a little skeptical, too.
Well,
how much would it be?
Well, we don't know, because
they
have...
5,000.
Yeah, here it's 5,000.
Oh, right, and it can be as low as... Okay. Yeah, we'll figure
it
out.
Wait, as low as what?
500.
500.
Yeah.
We'll figure it out.
Depends on what I roll.
Yep.
Bro. Mm-hmm. Bro. Okay.
Bro.
Let's go back to Tour Lane.
Right away?
Yeah.
What?
What?
What about Scott?
Scott.
Oh, the donkey.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the oh.
We gotta go get him.
Remember that town
he was a gift?
Remember?
Oh,
we were
I'm trying.
The trees.
Will you fucking let me speak? I'm not daft. Oh, I mean, I am, but I'm not that daft. I'm just trying to say it was a gift from Statler, so we should probably keep it.
Yep.
Exactly.
Alright. So, can we go to Scott? I'm sorry.
How are we going to explain that we need to go to the town?
Oh my god.
They can take you to any city.
Let's go to Fallbrook, guys.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Such a sweet town.
Wait, what about the temple?
No.
No.
Ulfgar?
But that's where Scott is.
Yeah. But he can only take us to cities, so we
should just go to
Fallbrook. Keep up, Ulfgar.
That's on the dummy, the boy.
I'll second that.
He's the asshole.
I'll second that.
Four Aladrin stand behind you, place their hands on your shoulder. You're surrounded by mist. The mist becomes so thick, you can't even see the tip of your nose.
You even vape, bro?
Oh, God.
When the mist clears, you're standing in the main street of Fallbrook. The elves,
different here.
The elves take their hands off your shoulders and they disappear into the mist.
Huh.
It smells different here.
Does it smell different?
It does, actually. And it's quite warmer.
How long were we gone for?
I don't know. Do we know what day it was when we left?
It was, beginning of June.
I woke up to a random person on the street.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what day it is?
Yes, it's August 1st.
Great, thank you. And I walk away. So, it's August 1st.
Oh, shit.
Scott's been alone for 2 months.
Scott's easily not here.
We should go. Let's go see if we can find him.
Is there a point?
There might. He might be there.
Wait, let's ask her then.
I go to the same person who's probably like talking
in the car.
Oh boy.
Oh fuck! Let's go see
him. Sir, person.
Yes.
Have you heard news of a donkey?
Oh my god. Well, 2 months ago.
In the roundabouts?
No.
He was, in the forest. We lost him.
He's also 2 days away.
No.
Shit. Let's just go.
Guys. If we find him,
if we go to the
temple, he will literally be dead.
If we go to the temple right now, Scott's gonna be dead. One.
We're gonna waste 2 days. We have to go
4 days.
Yeah, 4 days. We have to get
back
to Fallbrook,
and then another 4 days.
That
is 4 days that they will be working on our fucking armor.
That's true. That's true. He makes a good point.
What about Scott?
Fuck Scott.
Remember
Fuck Scott.
All the shit we got to get him back after he was kidnapped?
Yeah. Remember? Remember
He's
who
probably,
he was from?
It's
I'm gonna start walking
months.
Towards Torlemaine.
Ulfgar, you remember who we got him from?
Yeah, he's dead.
Disgraceful.
I'm over it.
Wait, what was the terrain around the temple? Was there grass?
It was in the forest. There was plenty of vegetation.
It's Probably
or a wolf got him.
He's probably fine.
Donald was with him.
I really don't want.
Why don't you two go, and we'll head back to Tourlamine.
Really?
I don't like that idea.
Really?
Why not?
How far away is Tourlamine? We know
4 days.
4 days.
Yeah.
You guys have a donkey, though. Couldn't you catch up to the people walking?
Yeah, especially with a lighter load, you'd probably get to Tourlamine at about the same time.
We'd get there around the same time, guys.
Mara, I want to go get Gott.
Well, let's see. 6 days on donkey, but
so we can still do the initial plan on our way back. Because fuck these two.
Initial plan.
You know, the trees.
We're in the fucking town right now.
Yeah. She can just do that right now.
Oh, yeah, I suppose.
Why don't you go do that? We'll discuss. Let the grown-ups talk.
You're not wearing your hat right now, Mora.
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, she is.
Oh, I didn't realize you put it on.
Yeah, it's on my head.
What are you talking about? She looks completely different. Well, the same.
Oh, dear lord.
I'm gonna kill all of you people.
What do you want to do, Mara?
Okay, so actually the donkey party would only be 2 days behind the other guys.
Granted, they don't meet their demise, but creatures.
There's also the possibility of us dying.
Which, if you...
We're pretty great.
Which, if you remember, this area of the kingdom is much more heavily patrolled recently due to the cultist activities that took the town.
So well, probably I actually seem to remember.
I'm saying the area is probably more safe than normal.
See, it's safe, guys.
Oh, yeah, the patrol is very heavy. There's heavy patrol. So we should be fine. However... I just really want to get this armor made, but really badly.
Who's giving the armor?
Me and Keenan.
Yeah.
Me and Torment. Hmm. Ulfgar and Torment. Torment and I.
Not the rogue?
Yeah, that's kind of what I was wondering. Why would the rogue get some? That'd when be really good for the
get
rogue.
For attunement.
Yeah. I'd get rid of my hat.
And then you cast Minor Illusion on yourself.
Yeah.
It's Ulfgar's to give.
That's hard, though.
It'd be really good.
Yeah, it would.
Yeah, but without it, will Torment get picked off really easy?
No, because he'll just buy regular armor.
Yeah, then I'll just buy regular armor.
Yeah.
Probably.
I'd say we could just trade, but that's not gonna work.
Spirit, no puppy.
That might be the best plan.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
But... what kind of armor would you take then? Just like
breastplate.
Well, you said I couldn't make a breastplate with it though.
Yeah, breastplate you can.
Not with the Elder Shadow Drake.
He's talking about Mara.
Oh, probably studded leather.
But her mithril's a lot better.
Yeah, her mithril might
like her AC 16. Would drop a ton.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. Okay.
The
so
mithril is not plus one though.
It's plus two.
What?
When I bought it, you said it was a plus two to my AC.
Okay, you're confused. It adds to... Wait, it's not a plus two armor, is it?
So...
That doesn't sound right.
It should just be...
Studded leather would actually
mithril chain shirt.
Unless it's just how I put it in here, so it made my AC 16.
Oh, it would be two more AC than leather.
Yeah.
Because it's a chain
yeah,
shirt.
So that's how I got it. Yeah.
What's up?
Wait, what's the mithril armor made of?
Mithril.
That's it? That's like a chain shirt?
Yeah, it's a chain shirt made of mithril links.
Oh, yeah.
So you could sell that.
You would have studded leather, which is 13, plus your dex.
So my AC would be the same.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, no, that's much better.
Mithril is a light, flexible material. A mithril chain shirt or breastplate can be worn under normal clothes if the armor normally imposes disadvantage on dexterity stealth checks or has a strength requirement. The mithril version of the armor doesn't.
I know, when you originally sold it to her, you had it way different than what it says in the book.
Yeah.
I think you used a Google off of it.
Yeah, I think you might be right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, Mora, this armor allows us to teleport through the shadows.
So what, okay, question. If, what else are you going to do with the rest of it then? If because
yeah,
she
there's a big difference
it.
Between a tiefling and a gnome. So you could maybe sell some?
Yeah, I would.
Okay.
Maybe that would just cover the cost of the armor completely.
That'd be sweet.
Leather armor is 11 plus dex modifier for AC. Chain shirt is 13 plus dex modifier max 2.
What's a studded leather?
Studded leather is 12 plus dex modifier. But this is also going to be... You're trying to make it plus 1.
So you can go back up to 16.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's if. That's a big
if.
If
prices are good.
And it weighs 7 less pounds. And then you can teleport through shadows 3 times a day.
Yeah, I would.
And it looks badass.
Oh god, it would look so good.
It's probably worth the drop, ain't it?
Yeah. It is.
Even if it's not a...
And mithril armor is uncommon, so you could sell the mithril armor and recoup some of your losses.
I just imagine the fucking barbarian being right here, but then, wah, 60 feet over, look, javelin of lightning.
Yeah.
Lightning javelin flies out of nowhere. Oh, God, yes.
Oh, God.
Okay.
So question about, like, jumping through. This may not be the right time. When I if I use my action to travel through the shadows, do I then have to make a sneak to like be hidden in the shadows, or?
I believe.
Or am I just hidden?
I believe some classes you can do the hide action as a bonus action.
Oh, so I would
just rogue.
That's just me.
So okay. I would just travel.
Yeah.
But and that uses did that just use my movement or my entire action?
That uses your action.
So if it works like Dimension Door, can they take people with them?
No.
Okay.
It only works like Dimension Door.
I mean, they're both
Dimension
tiny
Door anyway,
yeah. So they wouldn't be able to take.
Yeah, it wouldn't take too much.
So yeah, no, this armor is the best for the rogue.
Yeah, you two are gonna be teleporting everywhere. I'm gonna be.
I don't even know. Maybe I might just.
They'd be left on the floor.
Depending, if I can... I'm going to check if they have bracers again. And I might just sell it. Because, like, if I use my full act... I'm a heavy hitter. I can't really afford to...
You are a heavy hitter.
To, like, take an action to just teleport randomly.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
So I could either give it to, like, Keenan.
Really? There's only one use I want for it is...
The teleportation?
No, I'm killing her father.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I want to be able to use this armor for, is killing her father.
That would have been brilliant.
Yeah.
You just teleport right in there.
Yeah.
Murder the fuck out of him.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to happen soon. Okay, so, you're going to separate for a little while?
I guess.
Ulfgar and I will go
get
your armor ready.
Yeah.
Okay. And us two are going to go get Scott.
We're going to look for Scott.
It's fine.
Okay. So, Torment and Ulfgar are heading back to Torlemain. Sarvak and Mara are going to go search for Scott.
Yep.
Oh shit, that was a stupid idea.
Why?
No.
Getting back into Torlemain.
There's entrances.
There's
we're going
entrances
down.
Just
on
the
outside.
About.
Yeah.
Outside
the
city.
And you still have your hat.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're good.
So.
Okay.
It takes you some time, but you do find where the temple was. If I remember correctly, you left Scott outside but not attached to the cart so that he could graze freely.
Yes.
You tied him to a tree. You find a tree with a rope bitten through.
Saw that. Go ahead.
Inside the cart, some of the rations are, like, ripped open and eaten.
Donald? The hand? Hey, Donald!
Did you see where Scott went? If so, take us there.
He just runs off.
Let's follow.
Well, yeah. I guess.
You go for about 40 feet and then he kind of stops at, like, an area of brush.
I figured. He didn't see anything past here.
Oh, yeah.
Duh.
The good thinking, though. You have a direction.
Oh, that's true. We do.
You weren't even thinking that?
Nope.
We'll call it Dragonborn intuition.
At least we ported back to Torlemaine. Oh wait, we didn't.
Oh god, too bad we didn't have this discussion. Otherwise, me and you could have already ported back, and they could have just. That's upsetting.
No, but we didn't know because of the time difference.
I'm gonna take a page out of Ulfgar's book, and I'm gonna look around for an animal.
Okay. Let's see.
In my book, I usually kill them.
Yeah.
So
it's just a page.
It's actually written. The book's half a page. I can't read or write.
There is a.
It's actually. Okay.
Psst.
I'm looking for an animal. Shut up.
There is a nest and a family of blue jays nearby.
I hate birds.
Come on. I can cook it over my blade.
Oh my God. You just shut up. Hey, birds!
Yeah!
You see a donkey anywhere? Like, lately? Or for a while?
Persuasion.
So what I'm going to say.
Oh, fuck.
Because it can't read you what you will. It's about... It says this. Foreign animal. Keen if it won't be friend.
I got a 6.
Oh!
So, you didn't do so bad.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a donkey that lives around here. Why?
Can you tell me where he is?
I don't know where it is right now.
Can you help me look for it? I'll give you some nuts.
Roll at advantage.
Yes. Oh, yes. 20!
Oh, I got an 18.
Oh!
Yes. Thank God for advantage.
Yeah. What was your first one?
3.
Oh. All right, we'll help you. I got free food.
So
what?
Go get some rush.
Free food.
Okay.
So they just kind of scatter. And then after about 10 minutes, they come back. One by one, after a little while. He says, yeah, I found him. He's this way.
Okay.
Like, how do you... You can't fly, though, so...
I can.
Okay. Bird takes off.
I take off after him.
Okay.
Even though I can't talk to it.
I'm just going to assume Mara relays the message.
Yeah. Why don't you carry Mara?
Actually, I'll have my shield carry her.
Okay.
Wait, I thought you unattuned to that.
Yeah, I thought you unattuned to it.
Like a while
ago. Yeah.
And sold
yeah.
it.
Yeah,
I thought
you sold that thing.
I did sell that. I did sell that.
I liked that shield.
God. Yeah, you were like kind of upset when you were selling it. You're like, wait, you're selling my shield? And
yeah.
Like,
I sold the
cool
eye
shield.
Like the day after.
Yeah, you did.
You didn't really have much of use for it. You didn't have much of use for your shield.
My bone javelin, though.
Yeah, that survived.
Okay, so I'm assuming the bird and Sarvak take off.
Mm-hmm. They take off, and Sarvak, you follow the bird to a donkey who has a rope around his neck, and part of that rope is chewed off.
Who you can't talk to.
I'll go to the ground,
mm-hmm.
just be like, it's got... Grab the rope and... Try to lead it back.
Okay, make an animal handling check.
Oh, boy.
I hope you're bad at those.
That's plus 3.
If you come, I'm giving nuts to all the birds that searched for me.
Okay.
13?
Yeah, that's good enough.
Okay.
You know how not to tug Spirit too up. Hard. And donkey hasn't seen you in a while.
The fucking dragonborn just like, ooh, like lift it up. Here you go.
And you lead Scott back to Mara.
Scott!
I found him.
I see that.
You were gone for so long.
I'm sorry, Scott.
Where did you go?
A long ways away. I'm sorry. We didn't mean to.
Okay. I ate some of your food.
That's okay. How many rations are left in the cart?
He ate about 6 before he started getting tired of overly salted goods.
Keenan, you know what we didn't get?
You guys didn't get rations?
Oh, yeah.
It's fine.
I didn't give you any.
We're foraging.
I can hunt.
Yeah.
With what? Eldritch Blast.
Dude, my bow?
Yeah.
So I attack Scott back and we
I have my javelin. Can I use my lightning javelin to cook it?
Oh my god.
So, back to the other side of the party.
Oh my god.
Who didn't grab any rations?
You just realized after you parted ways, you know, after about 6 hours of walking, you start getting hungry.
Oh shit.
Better grab some
rations. Town, don't forget to poison you.
Ulfgar?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
we don't have rations.
Oh, just realized that too.
Yep.
So I always carry some.
Yep.
Well, I don't know why I don't carry them.
Me neither.
I'm like a fucking bear.
So.
I carry a lot. This is unfortunate.
Yeah.
So, what are we doing? Hunt. I'm gonna try to find an animal. You should do.
Okay.
We're gonna hunt. Survival.
10.
12.
Ulfgar.
Yep.
It's starting to get dark.
I bet.
You see a raccoon in a tree.
All right. I look at the raccoon. I eye it down. And I throw a javelin at it.
Okay. Roll the hit.
Nine?
Samantha, do you have any paper towels?
Oh, yes.
What happened?
Nine hits.
Oh, thank God. Do you want me to roll damage?
Sure.
6.
Six kills the raccoon.
Eldritch Blast!
Oh, yeah. Okay, roll a hit.
No, I'm sorry. I was
thinking
of
No.
I'm the only one that found a raccoon. Yeah, I'm going to look for... More animals.
I'm gonna keep looking for animals too.
Okay, it's starting to get dark now, so
that wasn't good.
Oh,
that's a 4.
14.
Okay, yes. Samantha, what is a smaller animal that Torment could come across?
Please let it be a squirrel.
A beaver.
A beaver.
Hell yes.
There's a small river, really more of a large stream nearby, and there is a beaver swimming in this body of water.
I see him. I'm gonna shoot him with my bow.
Okay. Roll to hit.
16.
You hit. Roll for damage.
What's a longbow again?
D10.
Is it a D10?
No, Sharpo is a D6.
I thought it was a D8.
Maybe it's a D8 though.
Yeah, D8
sounds
right.
I want to be an asshole and make Keenan kill a skunk.
Longbow?
D8. I know!
Yeah.
6 plus 12. 12 points.
Yeah.
Your mod is plus 6? Yeah. Oh, I guess because it's your charisma.
Oh, no. It's just a 11. Because it's only a plus 1 if it's my packed weapon.
Oh, okay.
It's
okay.
Not my packed weapon.
I got you.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. You shoot, hit, and kill the beaver. It is now floating in the river.
Ah, shit.
Yeah, I could swim.
Yeah, you're both together.
Are we? Oh, sweet. Oh, go.
If you separate, then that'd be stupid.
That's true, that would be stupid.
Okay, yeah, you get advantage on swim checks.
As athletics?
Yeah.
18.
Yes, you use your new javelin to float.
You go and collect the beaver.
You now have a raccoon and a beaver.
Hey,
I learned a lot from that swamp, from the sewer. Look.
Yeah.
Do you know how to cook?
Yeah.
Okay.
I never told you this. Whenever I do my watch, I usually find an animal, skin it, and cook it. That's probably why I got so good at so I could skin the drake. That's probably why.
Okay.
That's definitely why.
Can you? Yeah.
It's because I killed this. I prepared.
Can you just cook it?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Okay. Let's go back to a campsite.
Okay.
All right. And we're gonna have to do this like 6 times.
Do you even have any wood to burn?
4 times actually.
Fucking, do you need a dagger? To skin it?
I have a dagger.
Do you want a skinning knife?
Yeah.
I conjure a skinning knife.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
Just don't be 5 feet away from me.
We're buddy.
Yeah.
Okay. Survival?
Okay. Survival.
11.
Yeah, that it's pretty simple.
Okay, for both of them, or do you want me to roll another one?
Another one.
20.
There you go. Yeah, you're able to skin the raccoon and the beaver.
Okay.
Beaver pelts can sell for a good amount, too.
Well, we're going to keep both of these pelts.
Good. I don't know how much a raccoon pelt is, but we got a beaver pelt, too. So I'm going to write those down.
Oh, and then we're going to cook it over fire.
Okay. Yeah, you make sure not to pierce the stomach while you're skinning the animals. Contents would ruin the meat. Both of you roll another survival check.
Shit. 5. 16.
Okay, so Ulfgar, you know that if you just kind of throw the organs off to the side, just like 10 feet away, that would probably attract bears. So
I'm gonna go discard the organs.
In the river?
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah.
How far away is the river? Like,
well, let's just say you skin it at the river and then take the the animals and carcasses back.
Solid.
You do your field stripping of the animals there and then come back and then
yeah, that makes sense. Do it there for prosperity.
Yeah.
Love it. And I just have the beaver pelt, right? Because I got the 20 on it. Not the raccoon pelt, because I got an 11.
The raccoon pelts don't really sell for much.
Yeah, so we're just going to fuck it.
Yeah.
Nah, never mind. I was going to use it as a pillow. Not going to do that.
pillow cover. So yeah, you've got a decent amount of meat.
I'm going to like kind of cure the beaver pelt as well with the smoke.
Okay. So there's your first night.
Do you want me to roll survival for the belt, just curing it?
Yeah.
15.
Yeah, that's good enough. Okay, so you collected enough meat for 3 meals.
Hell yeah.
Dinner, breakfast, and lunch. Time for dinner again, so.
Oh, natural one!
It's okay, I got a 17.
Okay, Ulfgar, you found a deer, but you scared it away.
Damn it.
17. What's a good animal for a 17, Samantha?
How dangerous do you want it to be?
Not really dangerous. Grasslands, 17.
A cougar.
I'm thinking deer.
Another deer?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you scare the first deer away. Change locations, and there's another deer. It stands still, looking at you.
I shoot it with my longbow.
Okay.
With a 21.
Not bad, you hit.
That's good.
7.
You tag the deer, but the deer runs off.
Oh, shit! Wait, can I still
shoot? Can I shoot again?
I'm gonna throw my javelin.
Okay.
17 to hit.
Disadvantage because it's so far away.
17 to hit.
Okay, yeah, you hit.
8 points of damage.
And it's down.
Cool. Hey. We're high
five.
Pretty
good at this.
Survival, buddy.
The end.
Till the end.
And it deals a good amount of venison, too.
Yeah.
So somebody skin it.
Fuck. Here's your skinning knife again.
Ooh, that one's good. 18.
Yeah, there you go.
Deer hide worth anything?
Yeah.
Cool.
Hey.
Not much.
No. But, you know, we're gonna make some money in this endeavor.
Yeah.
If we have to.
A deer will probably provide you with enough venison for the trip back to Tormund.
Hell yeah! Whoop, whoop. We're the best.
Would it even be preserved for that long?
Meat can last a couple days the cart. Well, the cart's going to be behind you.
I'm also curing the deer hide already.
Yeah.
So I can cure meat at the same time.
Okay.
Because I can smoke it.
Yeah. So, 2 more days to Torlemaine. You get there and you head down to the Exanimate Cabal. Presumably, your friends are 2 days behind you.
Yep. Okay.
Hey, Ulfgar.
Yeah.
When we talk to Caecilius.
Yes.
Okay, I have a secret to tell you.
Oh, okay.
Unlock secrets.
So, you know the mask? You know how you killed Vecna?
Oh, shit. Gay, yeah, I'm gonna die.
No, you didn't, but...
Oh, thank God.
That I made that mask.
Oh, really?
Because I was talking with Vecna.
Yeah.
And I put the mask on.
Oh.
And it went into my face.
Into your face.
Yeah.
Your face looks the same.
I know. All the way in, I guess.
Oh, so it's like
yeah, that's where I got these new abilities from, Halberd.
You know, I was wondering about that.
Yeah.
It makes sense.
That's why Aurox isn't around.
Ah! Do the others know?
No.
I'll keep it hush.
Thank you.
The back is bouncing off everybody.
Remember last time I was supposed to keep something hush?
Shut up.
Aurox.
What?
You hear a voice.
Say what? Aurox?
Aurox.
Do I know where it came from?
Make a perception check.
That's not it. Fucking whores. Natural.
I'm gonna make a perception as well.
You do not hear this.
I don't hear. Oh, good.
Torment thinks that Ulfgar just said
Aurox.
Did something cool with his voice.
Okay, why are you talking about Aurox?
What are you talking about?
You just said Aurox.
Oh, what are you talking about, your face?
Oh my god. Seriously, dude, you just said Aurox.
Like,
you said it like 5 seconds ago. How do you not remember this?
I didn't say anything.
Aurox.
Can I find it again?
Try again.
That one.
Ooh, oh. Perception?
Yeah.
17.
It's coming from your shadow.
Can I, like, look under my lips?
Yeah.
Is that you? I'll bring my puppy out.
I remember this name.
Oh, puppy, you do.
Aurox.
Are you Aurox? You see nothing, by the way.
You just see him talking to
oh,
himself.
What the fuck are you doing, Tommy?
This name feels so familiar.
So, yes? What I'm gonna call you Aurox.
Tommy! No. Hello!
What do you want? I'm busy!
It would be really funny right now.
What?
If you punched me, and then they fell to one.
Oh my god! I punch him right in the gut.
Oh, jeez. Roll damage. No,
oh,
you don't need to roll
okay,
damage.
Okay, no, dude.
Oh, 3 minus 2.
Everyone takes 1 point of damage.
To their gut.
Yeah.
Oh, what the fuck? Mara, did you feel that?
Of course I did. Look at the string.
It's just flashing red.
You know those fuckers are doing something over there.
Nah, they probably think
how much
we're
you
fighting.
Want to bet how much you want to bet they're fighting?
They're probably or they're doing that stupid, hey, I'm going to fake punch you thing and try robbing a store and actually hit each other.
Yeah.
Well, Ulfgar and I actually were hitting each other.
Dude, we did. We did not fake it.
Yeah,
we weren't faking it one
we
bit.
We straight up had
don't
a
do that anymore.
Aw, yeah, we can't do that
we're getting,
anymore.
Like, natural 20 when hitting each other.
I know.
Jeez, yeah.
That was going
we,
so
we
well.
We got legitimately pissed. That was a great episode.
That was.
Oh, hey. We should go so we can get this armor prepared.
Yeah, let's do it, buddy.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
I'll talk to you later. Put my shadow back.
Who the fuck? Who?
Who
are you gonna talk to?
This name feels comfortable.
Good. That's your name.
My name's Ulfgar.
Yes, it is. I was confused for a second.
You
fucking idiot.
You are confused. You're the one fucking talking to yourself for a minute.
Did you not see him?
That, why would I? Wait, see, all
right.
Wait,
what? Watch my shadow.
Okay.
Puppy comes out. Shadow's gone.
Why'd you do that?
Oh, he's right there.
Wait. Right here!
Oh, nothing.
Ah, I put my shadow, they meld into his shadow.
Oh, jeez, you are overwhelmed with the feeling of doom.
Oh, God.
This is Aurochs.
I really want to steal some things. Stop it, hand. Don't do it.
Okay.
He's trying to choke you.
He comes back out.
Oh, feel better. Still wants to touch the loop.
Psycho?
It's not me, it's my hand. Uh-huh. It never happens in that battle.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Let's go. Let's go.
You head down. It...
I'm just imagining Casilla is like overhearing this somewhere.
We're not there.
You head down through the Undercity and into the Exanimate Cabal.
Ooh, no joking.
Hey, we're back!
You just kind of shout out the closed door.
Ulfgar, the door needs to be opened.
Oh, I open it. Hey, we're back!
The door does not open from the outside.
Oh, dear lord.
Knock, knock!
Oh, yeah, there are names.
Oh, God, I don't remember the phrase.
No!
Did you just feel chill?
It's did you just feel a chill?
Yeah.
It reminds me of a nightmare I recently had.
Yep.
Notes.
Where are the names? Oh, here we go. Okay. Like a little small door opens up, and you can see the familiar ghostly face of...
Herma
Ames.
What's up, Herma?
The ghost.
Hey, baby. What's up?
Oh, my God.
We're back.
Oh, you are. Did you just feel a chill?
It reminds me of a nightmare I recently had.
Welcome home.
Thank you.
Little door closes, big door opens.
We walk in.
Why didn't she open the door if she's a ghost?
Courtesy.
Oh, I was just thinking like that she could like phase through.
Who is it?
Bitch!
Hello. It's me, Herma. Oh, hey guys, we're back. You know, the real OG. Tolman Novgar.
Hey.
A wraith standing by you recognize as Eleanor Crane looks you over and says,
I've been here longer than you have. You're not original gangsters at all.
Oh, we're the best.
Oh. Where? That's a good point. I'm sorry. I was drunk with power.
Oh, aren't we all?
Where is Caecilius?
Caecilius is sitting at the front of the hall in his usual spot.
I was gonna be like, yo, what's up, Caecilius?
He's joined by Vishkrogar, the death tyrant, undead beholder, skull.
So I walk up to Caecilius.
What's up, Caecilius? Oh, he's gonna be pissed that we're not with Mara.
Vishkrogar is there as well.
Hello, everybody.
Hello. How are you?
Good. We're good.
Great, even good.
I notice you're missing two of your members.
Yep, they decided they needed to go find a donkey.
Right.
They're right behind us, don't worry.
They're coming.
How long?
Day,
maybe two.
Okay, how did things go? You've been gone for so long.
Yeah, so this one killed Vecna.
yeah, you're gonna have to roll for that.
I get really flush in the face and be like, oh, I did it.
Couldn't help it.
Yeah, I got a 25.
Damn it.
I was really hoping you'd get a nat 20.
Well, and isn't Caecilius like on to your line all
the time? Yeah. I can't not. It's a disease.
And now he's just kind of watching Ulfgar's reaction.
How... I didn't do it! It was the hand! It's evil! Like more evil than me? Like, in a way, it's almost good. Like, evil to good. Evil people is good in a way. It likes to do good. I don't know. Is there a boob I can touch? It really wants to touch a boob. I'm sorry, Kate.
So, what have you been doing?
So, time for the real story, Caecilius.
Please.
We Went to the temple.
Yeah.
There's some freaky deaky shit going on there. We, the cleric dude actually did some cleric stuff. And
cleric dude.
Rogue girl.
Yeah, she did some cleric shit. And we went to the Shadowfell. So that happened. And we had this mask that Vecna was talking to us through.
Really? Do you still have it? I'd very much like to
see it. I broke it.
Ulfgar, what did I tell you?
To tell the truth?
No, that's not
the truth. Oh, wait, that was a mask teammate. It was a decoy.
The mask, unfortunately, cannot be accessed.
And why is that?
It's in my face.
Vishkrogar, do you think we should prepare surgery?
No. Vecna is like part of me or something? Because you know how I had like the little dude flying around with me all the time and had all those cool like mind powers and could speak to you telepathically?
You're familiar.
Yeah. Him? Yeah, that none of that. That's all gone.
Why is that?
Because I gave up. I don't even remember his name anymore. Nyarlathotep.
Well, what do you remember? Because like, you forgot about everything.
He remembers the details, but he doesn't remember the process.
Yeah.
The function.
Yeah,
I gave him up as my pet patron. And
I see.
Have decided to follow Vecna. And he's granted me some quite interesting abilities.
Okay, I understand now. And the mask must have been this catalyst for this change.
Seems like it. Put the mask on, it melded into my face.
Unfortunate. I would have liked to have met him. But if
you will soon, because...
Yes, if
and
you
then
continue
I pull
to
out
be
the seed
successful,
of might.
Which
Wait,
is about this
seed?
Big. And
I thought... I took it.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's be realistic. I'm the pack mule. I would easily have the seed.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
true.
Yeah.
I pull out the seed of Mike.
Okay.
Out of
we
my...
have this.
It's as tall as you.
Well, no, it's like a football.
Oh, like a football. You're like this is like a football.
See you, Mike.
I remember them being longer. Well, whatever. It's like wider at the base.
Oh, okay.
Like, up, so.
We got some Mike here.
We got this thing.
So...
Oh, we also went to the Feywild.
Yeah, that's what we got the Seed of Might.
And the Plane of Mirrors.
I thought...
We took the Plane of Mirrors from the Shadowfell to the Feywild.
Been plane hopping.
I see.
For ourselves. I killed most of us.
There was this peculiar...
You don't
peculiar
appear to be dead.
...thing that
oh,
fell from the sky.
Mirror-like beings. They looked exactly like us. They fought like us. But I overpowered all of us. I'm the best.
God.
I overpowered
I
myself
see.
As well.
I mean, look at my beautiful,
Nope.
Nat 20.
No.
It seems like there's more to this encounter with yourselves than what you initially... You say you overpowered yourself. Can you tell me exactly, without lying, what
yeah.
happened?
So, true story coming on ya.
I hope so.
I was fighting, and I was doing okay, and then he failed a spell, and something fell on him.
Oh.
Weird as hell.
Yeah, it was like, can I like draw it out on my...
Sure.
I draw out the card. This thing.
I have no idea what that is.
Yeah,
it looks
neither.
Like a wagon. Not a wagon, a stagecoach.
It was made out of metal, though. All of it.
And like, had no area for horses.
No.
Well.
It's in the Plane of Mirrors now, so.
Oh, we got this! And I'm like going to, like, kind of, like, unroll the Elder Shadow Drakehide.
Oh, my.
Oh, yeah, we killed that, too.
Yeah, I'm good at skinning things.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Your beer.
My beer?
It's
oh,
nice.
Yeah, you're good. It's done.
I'm gonna laugh at the mob truck at all.
Oh, how is my servant doing?
I have no idea. I don't pay attention to those kinds of things.
That was my bad. I realized that you wouldn't really give a
you
shit.
You might want to go check on him.
I'm gonna roll up my hide and I'm gonna go check on Mop and Terry.
Oh
my god, imagine if I didn't get Mop. Terry would be super dead.
Yeah. Oh yeah, quite. So you'll leave for now.
Yep.
Alright, so I think I have an understanding of what's going on.
Yeah.
So you have a seed of a tree of might.
Correct, yep. And we Vecna told us we had to kill a land spirit, right?
Was it louder?
Vecna told us we had to kill a land spirit, right?
Yeah.
Yes, he did.
And Vecna would like us to kill a land spirit.
I'm sorry, is he insane?
Well, he told... Okay, this is out of character right
okay.
now.
Okay.
After the session one time, you told me that he was supposed to tell us about the cyst.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Was that like...
I missed that. My
did
bad.
Did that just... Do I know that from the mask?
No.
We don't know about it at all then?
No.
That's right, you do not.
Well, that's unfortunate. Do you know of any way to weaken a land spirit?
I'm afraid I don't. Sorry, go back to this killing a land spirit business.
Oh, yeah. So you know the prophecy?
Yes.
That Mr. Badass told us. He...
Our esteemed founder.
Yes. He's pretty badass.
Yes, he is. Please continue.
So, yeah, Vecna wants us to kill a land spirit. And he said that it has to be done. And then we have to plant the seed of the might in the land spirit, it'll grow big, and then Mara has to touch it.
Okay, I see. That's replacing the land spirit with the tree of might that Mara will then touch.
Yes.
And fulfill the prophecy.
Correct,
okay,
yeah.
I see. Because if you had... just decide to simply kill a land spirit, you might destroy the entire region of land that he's protecting.
Well,
that would be bad for all of us, I'm afraid.
Well, absolutely. That's why we're going to plant a seed in him.
Was it in him, or was it like at his like altar or some shit?
It was in
I thought it was in the land spirit after we killed it.
I don't remember.
Yeah.
Well, we'll still remember.
No.
And I'm not hearing this.
Very well. Please make yourselves comfortable while you wait for your companions.
Great. However, in order to do such a large feat, I believe we're going to need a bit better equipment. Is there any way you can help us out? We did just get the means to resurrecting our god.
Well, there's always the agent discount in our armory.
Is there anything else you can do for us, Caecilius?
I do not know where a land spirit is. In a few days' time, when your companions come back, we can perform a divination ritual and find out, and perhaps even with your involvement, we can find out where to get more information. Did Vecna give you any kind of information on how we may contact him in the future?
When the time is right?
No, he said to build an altar.
Oh, yes, build an altar to him. Shrine. I have a book.
Oh.
Prayers to Vecna.
Ooh, very nice.
I thought
nice.
I had that.
I took one for myself.
No, you each have one.
Oh, okay.
I think we'll get started on converting our church. Yes, if I could borrow that.
Absolutely.
Thank
you. You're 100% in charge of
it.
I saw that flash across your face, and then I saw the common sense gleam through. So, Ulfgar.
Yes.
You go running down the hallway and you rush into your quarters.
Yes.
Swing open the door.
Mob! I'm back!
Mop is sitting at a table, just kind of like laying on it, looking at the wall.
What have you been doing?
Oh, Master.
Oh, hello, Mop.
Terry as well. He is currently above ground.
I should have got you a book or something. Maybe you should have learned to read. You look really bored.
Much better than being a normal slave, but yes, I am quite... You've been gone for so long.
Yeah.
Are you well?
Well, why don't we take a nice bath and we can talk about it?
Yes, sir.
First, I'm going to speak with Terry.
Terry is above ground right now.
Oh!
Yes, he's at one of our stables.
I'm proud of you. Above and beyond.
Thank you. That is what you instructed me to do.
You look like this lady's what I tell you.
I...
But you did follow. I'll talk to him later.
Okay.
But now, let's go take that bath.
Yes, sir.
Is that ripe?
What?
Is that ripe? Do you not want to take a bath with your master?
I would prefer not to, sir.
Why not?
Oh, no.
Baths are things that you should do on your own.
Well, it's like a communal bath, isn't it?
Actually, I believe you're correct.
It is a communal bath.
Yes, sir.
And you think baths should be on your own?
I have intimacy problems, sir. It comes with the territory of being a slave.
Well, we're gonna break you out of this.
Yes, sir.
Have I ever been mean to you?
No, sir, you have not.
That's wrong.
That's wrong!
Do you not remember me mopping you in the face?
I believe that's simply power for the course, sir.
Oh, sorry, I was pretty drunk. But when was the last time you had a bath?
I believe the last time you requested my assistance in such matters.
Jesus, that was over a month ago.
2 months, I believe.
Jesus! That is worse than I thought! I don't really know how... It's August, right?
Yes, August,
How many days you've been traveling?
Four.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
August 5th.
It was only like a week and a... How long was it in our time?
Like, a few days.
Yeah, only
like
a few days.
Like, 4 days traveling, 2-6, so, and then when we were in there...
It's probably about a week.
About a week, like, a week and a half.
Yeah.
we went to different planes, and it was 2 months for you, it was a week and a half for me.
Goodness.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
I hope your journey proved entertaining, sir.
Oh, good lord, shit.
Good.
All right, let's go take that bath.
Yes, sir.
Be more chipper about it.
Chipper?
Yeah, happier.
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's
okay, so
Wait. You know, I'm proud of you.
Again.
No, I might not be the nicest person, but I do recognize good work.
Thank you, sir.
And I'm going to pay you 10 gold.
Very gracious, sir. Thank you so much.
Fucking great. Now take a damn bath with me.
Yes, sir. And as you go and you have your cooperative naked time with your slave.
It's very soothing.
I believe we will take a break. It looks like we've actually spent a lot of time with shopping and roleplay, so we will be back for part 2 after all. So, once again, thank you for watching.